after about 4 months of not doing this, I figured we would come back to it, and behold, here we are. What's going on, everybody, and welcome back to the Sideshow. This is KD Acoustics. I'm Chris, obviously the host of this bullshit. Anyways, yes, we are back with the Sideshow. Slow season is getting ready to start. I'm in the same shit as I was for the channel updates video. Funny thing, it's recorded the same night, and I'm going to go ahead and apologize for the lighting because, well, yeah, freaking, I have to do it in a new corner. My phone died. Anyways, though, without further ado, I'm going to quit bullshitting around with the, you know, intro and everything. Let's get rolling. So we got a couple little topics to jump in here. Nothing major and everything. Maybe one, you know, extremely controversial. And that's really what's going to be this first topic and stuff like that. You know, we got why this place or why this country and shit is getting so fucked up, which ain't going to be in the title, which, by the way, their language, because I'm going to have a lot of language in here, so might as well throw in a little bit of a warning. Anyways, guys, yeah, like I was saying, this country is pretty much fucked. We are in a fucked situation, and it's not like I'm sitting here talking about the social and political unrest that we've had the last year, 2 years, however long it's been, and then, of course, on top of all that, this fucking pandemic that happened and all that bullshit. Well, now it's got everybody scared to an unbelievable point and everything. And we got a government who is trying to play us from both sides. And a lot of people don't see it. Well, you know, if you look at it, they're starting to separate people out, vaccinated and unvaccinated and all that. But that's not even really what I'm trying to get into. If I wanted to ramble on about how the government's trying to fuck us over, I could do that all day long. But I'm not trying to sound like a doomsday prepper tonight. So with that being said, let's kind of break down into part of the reason on why this is getting out of hand. First off, under the pandemic and a lot of things going on, we have a lot of people who don't want to work. A lot of people who have signed on for unemployment, got it granted, they're getting their checks every week or every month or however you know that works, whether it's based on how they were getting paid whenever they were laid off or fired. And see, that's the thing, though. Now you got to be either fired or laid off or something like that to even get your unemployment. You can't just be up and be like, oh, yeah, fuck you, and then walk out the door and get your unemployment check. But, you know, that's besides the point that I'm making here, all right? It's basically the part of that everybody is so worried and scared about this virus that a lot of people just aren't wanting to work because of possible exposure and this, which a lot of the news media is kind of still making it out worse than what it is or what it needs to be, because under current statistics, there is still a 99.9% survival rate. That being said, all of you don't want to work. Y'all need to grow up and get the hell out the door and freaking go get a job, okay? Because all of this problem that everybody is being scared to work with, for whatever reason it is, of people saying, oh yeah, we can't find a job, or these employers ain't getting back to us, which I'll jump in a little bit, because I'm not saying y'all are wrong at all for the ones who have had that problem, because I had that problem there for a little while, okay? But there's a lot of things that are going on. Now, I'm not sure if all the whole 100% problem of these ships being stalled is just because they don't have enough workers to unload them. But that is also causing problems in transport of goods and everything. Stores are running low on supplies. You know, the big chains ain't necessarily running low. But, you know, you kind of get my drift. They're short-stacked on what they have, so they'll sell out of this quick, and they'll sell out of that quick. And the price of everything is also jumping up under all of this because of, you know, well, you got to pay for labor somehow. The minimum wage and the average prices of jobs is going up, so that's rising the price of supply and everything. So stuff is getting more expensive as that goes, but also looking at it, they don't have the workers to support the labor for either the processing or the shipping or anything like that. CDL drivers, food processing, manufacturing, anything right now is hiring, but a lot of people are looking at it and taking it off to the side like it's nothing, and they're like, yep, I can do this, all this shit sitting on my ass and everything. And, you know, that DoorDash or whatever, in my opinion, is a whole side hobby thing. I know people who are making not a killing off that, but a decent lick of money. Still, though, they ain't getting by. Though it is a job, so I'm not going to go into bashing all them other people. But if you catch my drift, this problem that we have with the shortage of either, you know, workers or labor or shortage of goods and stuff, look at the reason on why that is. Everybody's wondering, oh, well, why is that? Well, you know, some of you people who are able to work, not the ones who aren't able to work, you know, the ones with disabilities and functions that keep them ailments that keep them from working, but able-bodied Americans that can work need to get their ass back in the workforce, and then you'll start seeing the uptick, and then the prices start dropping again, even though the wages are still there, the supply is going up, the company's making money, and the materials are getting sold, so depending on how much it is, you know, even though some materials would be what, you know what, I'm getting into economics here. Besides the point, though, you all get where I'm going with that, and I'm pretty sure me leaving off with that speaks for itself, okay? So, now moving on to the next little piece. Alright, so another thing that it needs to be touched on to the subject of why this country is so fucked right now is we have a lot of big issues that seem to be being pushed to the side, and I'm not talking about things that have been brought up in the limelight as much as I am talking about the ones that have only been brought up a handful of times or, you know, maybe once and then never brought up again. You know, like, everybody knows about the stuff that happened in the Kabul, the 13 Marines, and my sympathy goes out to all of them. My dad is a fellow Marine and everything, so, you know, I know his heart's heavy for everybody in that regard. But other than that, though, the other situations like the Haiti, the church ministry, people getting kidnapped. All right, but how about looking into, you know, the North Korea? North Korea apparently has started their nuclear warhead or nuclear missile testing, whatever it may be again, okay? That is a sort of a problem because Trump either eliminated that problem or put a limit to that problem where they could only do so much here and there and everything like that, okay? But it's nothing new for North Korea to be doing that. Well, on the other hand now, you have South Korea that is missile testing as well. Now, I don't know if it's, you know, laser-guided missiles or what the hell it is. I heard it on the news one morning going to work, okay? Or the radio news or whatever you want to call it going to work. But if you look at that, in my brain, that kind of clicks. Oh, wait a minute, is there about to be conflict over there, you know? But I've only heard about it once. It was all pushed to the side. There wasn't a lot of information on it other than, you know, oh yeah, both sides are kind of missile testing. But there's a lot more going on too. And this is kind of crazy though because it kind of drives into the little conspiracy factor of, all right, obviously, you know, China's rebuilding their army, da 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 da. There's been talks and rumors throughout that. But you also got Russia who is building armor. And this armor is supposedly able to stop like a 50 caliber bullet or some shit like that. Really strong armor, okay? And, you know, just getting the wheels turning. And I don't know if it's just me or if there's a lot of other conspiracy nerds out there. Because, I don't know, I kind of like conspiracy. I probably got my head wrapped around it too much. And this crap went out. But, anyways, with that being said, and China's overbearing their army and Russia building that armor. What the hell is getting ready to happen with all that shit going on over there? Is there something that's getting ready to happen over there that we don't know about, okay? Is it getting ready to come a World War III? Is somebody getting ready to fuck up? Is somebody getting ready to make the first move, you know? There's just so many things that could toss and turn in your head over that one little subject. And it's crazy to think, man, that in just an instant, something could happen based off the information that you think is, you know, or that, if not you think, the information that is getting pushed off to the side and hid from the limelight rather than being frontline kind of things. In my opinion, it's a little shady. But besides that, I'm going to be done rambling. I kind of feel like that's all it is. None of this probably makes sense at this point, But we're going to move on to something else that makes a little bit of sense, and hopefully you moved on or you've kept along going on this far. Enough of the shit that makes me mad. Let's get ready to talk about something that's going on here in the next couple of weeks. As you know, we are going on to November, and I'm not talking about the start of modern gun seasons for a lot of places, including the state that I live in. No, I'm going to talk about No Shave November, and this is just going to be little brief bullshit, you know, about it and stuff. And it's all for a good cause, okay? I don't have any links, nor am I, you know, setting up a donation thing. I don't feel like my fan base is big enough, and, you know, you can do this on your own. It's just a little thing, you know, you can take your money. I think it's for men's cancer or men's colon cancer awareness. It's one or the other. I can't fully remember. I'm sorry that my information is not fully up to par on everything. But, yeah, it's been going on for a while. You know, all you got to do is just don't shave that whole entire month, okay? And then take all that money that you didn't spend on razors and, you know, donate what you would have spent off for that cause. What I know from what I've heard from everybody who's done it. I have participated in it. And, you know, now I just kind of, you know, it's a year-round thing almost. But, anyways, regardless of that, though, little tips for if you want to keep it going, if you move on, get the shape of your face, know how to trim it yourself, unless you want to go to a barber. But if you go to a barber, you know, start it whenever it's small, because if I would have started whenever my beard was first growing with a barber, I would probably have a lot more trust in who's touching my beard and going for the shape and all that, though. I just let my beard do its own thing, and right now it looks like it's going to be a tube beard. I'm not even worried about that, but yeah. Other than that, you know, oils, balms, all that. If you want more information, go view the last sideshow that was 4 months ago before we quit. I carried that over my slow season and everything, so yeah. Anyways, guys, that brings us to the end. Welcome back. The sideshow is finally here. Like I said, we are in October. It is the slow months. If you haven't checked out the channel updates video and you made it this far and you're a returning subscriber, I'll drop the link and leave it down in the description box. It'll tell you what's getting ready to come up on this channel, because I do have a couple big things. I am releasing one part of two on this playlist that I've been working on for a little bit. You're not going to see me playing the guitar and singing, but it is a all country and bluegrass playlist. And I call it Soulwater Revival. It is public, though you cannot watch any of the videos right now. But yeah, I'm going to release the first four, and then you can check out that video for the announcements on when the rest of the videos are going to be up on here, because I do believe it's like 10 or 11 songs. Anyways, guys, regardless of that, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, as long as you kept, or if you kept up with this excessive rambling bullshit. If you're new to the channel, please give it a hit that subscribe button, check out the music and all the other sideshows. The link to the playlist will be down in the description box below. And other than that, guys, that is it. Follow me on Instagram, also down in the description box, before I get off of here. Anyways, I'll see you guys in the next one.